What does this year hold for Kate then, primarily?
Her ambition is obviously to succeed in the music business.
No, I'll tell you what it is, it's the beginning of the documentary. Let's see, and this is a test of what a good manager Dave is, because if my single career doesn't take off this year, it's Reedy's fault. Like the
I'll be sacked.
I've spent the last 3 years with Katie Price, Jordan, as she's known to the rest of the world. When we first met, she was a page 3 pin-up, famous for her surgically enhanced figure, infamous for her outrageous lifestyle, a woman who knew just what the papers wanted. And that was what I filmed, Jordan, the photo shoots.
Come on, another roll.
Oh, chuck that. We've got 5 shots here. I've really got to go.
I filmed the drunken nights.
I'm pissed as a fart, but I'm still walking.
The celebrity boyfriends. I was filming when she conquered America with her first Playboy cover.
Richard, will you get away with that camera? Tell him off there, say, get out of here.
Get out of here.
But then I saw the other side of Jordan. I was with her when she arrived home to find the house burgled.
Look at that fucking mirror. Look, you bitch.
When she split up with her boyfriend Dwight York and then found out she was carrying his baby.
That's his head and his arms are sort of like that. And that's his belly, you can't see his legs because it's too big. So there's the proof, I'm not lying, it's not a publicity stunt.
And when her son Harvey was born, she discovered he was blind.
He's registered blind, not partially blind, blind.
Right, but
face it, Mum.
I'm not saying he's not, but he will see the difference between light and dark.
No, she said he's going to be registered blind,
well,
which means so blind
what?
As a stick.
And it wasn't just her mother that she fell out with.
You are a nosy man, aren't you, Richard?
Well, it's my job to be inquisitive.
I'll bet.
Now in our third year together, Katie's richer, more famous than ever. But to the public, she's still just Jordan, the glamour model with the big tits. When Katie Price was a young girl, she wanted to be a singer. And now she's decided to realise her dream. My question is, would anyone ever take her seriously? Kate is doing a photo shoot for a lads mag. Whilst in makeup, I ask her about the plans for her singing career.
So what sort of music have you gone for then?
Wait and see, Richard.
Oh, go on.
No, I'll talk about it after you've heard it and then I'll explain why.
Yeah.
There must be somebody you think you're inspired by.
Who you like to listen to?
So I don't know, I like to listen to all different people. Isn't my music range proper?
It does actually.
Do you think sound like anyone else?
Yeah, you know who I think you sound like.
Oh yeah.
Go on, who's that?
I get embarrassed when she says it because I don't think I do.
It was like, on certain like songs that she does, her voice reminds me of Leanne Rimes.
Now, if I've got a voice like her, then I should bloody hope to sell records. Hey.
And when do you hope to have a single out?
10 weeks.
10 weeks from now?
Yeah.
Is it?
Free your mind!
After 9 years as a model, Kate is still in huge demand. A front page photo shoot is another 5-figure sum in the bank. Today, it's Front magazine.
Hello, Rich.
Yeah,
we just need a little bit of...
You notice my eyelashes? Got blue on them, look.
That's great, just there, good. Nice one. All eyes and mouth and stuff there, good. Yeah, that's nice.
Her manager, Dave Reed, helped Kate become the most successful glamour model in Britain. But she wants him to launch her music career. It's a new world for both of them. I asked him what his approach was going to be.
Don't tell me, come on.
You've got to try not to put out anything which is too cheesy because she's going to get a lot of stick, it's going to get a lot of critics. They're going to give her stick for her music. Even if it's a great, great single, she's going to get that. But if it's a really bad, cheesy single, it's just going to be 100 times worse. So we've got to try and come out with some quality. We can't just rush it just for the sake of, hey, Jordan wants to release a single. It's got to be a good single.
Did we get our shots first?
Oh, Richard. Oh, Rich. There.
Good girl. And again.
Sneaky shot. Richard, you always film when I'm not imposing. Now do it. Perhaps better. You're trying that, but you're not stupid. You make out you are, but you're not. You're a crafty little sod, really.
Right, here we go. Quick poll with them up and then we should get the floor.
Come on.
Talk to me, Richard.
Give it some.
Talk to me and make it work for me.
I can't do that.
Sorry.
It's Kate's 25th birthday. Friends and family have arrived at her home in Brighton, dressed as pimps and prostitutes. They're heading to London, where Kate has hired a nightclub for the evening.
Nobody but you and me.
Her brother and the rest of the family are on the coach. It's chaos. Kate's mum invites me to join in.
Sit down now!
That is my mother's sister.
Mental, normal, abnormal.
I'm very normal. I know.
Family at the back. When we get out and find us all the press, please, please, please show me up.
Jordan, looking good, Catherine. Looking great, Jordan.
Mum, can you wait, Mum? Mother.
For several thousand pounds, a magazine had bought the exclusive rights to the event.
My name is Jessica.
She was sharing her birthday with her current boyfriend, Scott.
Yeah, this is obviously for OK. They bought the rights exclusive, so they obviously want to get some photographs. And got a bit of fun, got some cakes for Kate and Scott. Birthday cake. It's just a party, really.
Kate spent most of the evening being photographed with her celebrity friends. These included Gary Lucy, Dean Gaffney, and Richard Blackwood. Some fans from her website had won invites to the bash. They looked a bit stunned to find themselves in the VIP area. Kate's brother runs the Jordan website, and he introduced me to them.
Richard are the website winners from the fan club. Paul, Emma and Julie.
Hi.
Hello.
Hope you're enjoying yourselves. It's been a good night.
We are. We want to be famous though, so.
What had they done to win, I wondered.
Pardon? Ask these two guys, it's all up to them.
We have to say why you wanted to come to Kate's party. We have to give a reason. Why I wanted to come to Kate's party in 20 words. And I said, well, how else am I going to give her a birthday kiss if she needs a nice guy to represent the club? And I won.
What did I write? I thought that I enjoy musical chairs and I like birthday cake. It was just supposed to be a joke, I never win anything.
It's exciting and it's
it's weird to know how the other people live, I suppose. Everybody dreams of being rich and famous and well known, and you come in here and you see all these different people and you think, oh my God, I know you. They don't know us. We're just normal everyday people. We've got boring everyday jobs. It's just basically we want to be them. But it's just exciting, really.
Exciting but surreal. Yeah.
Yeah,
been a good
definitely.
Night then. Very glad you invited us.
The party went on till 4 in the morning, but Kate didn't get to see much of her family. It was too packed in the VIP room. When we came out, there was over 50 photographers waiting. Each one was hoping to catch an exclusive, a shot of Jordan, drunk and falling over. It's worth thousands of pounds. The coach to take Kate back to Brighton was nowhere in sight, and the press scrum moved up and down the road as we looked for it. Tempers were frayed. It was half an hour before we got to safety. Once back on the coach, Kate took the mic and serenaded everyone on the drive back to Brighton.
With my boo, like, crazy over you, like, no matter what I do.
But she didn't want to be filmed.
Who wants to hear me singing?
I do.
Richard, turn the camera off, like, you've taken the piss all night, right? Don't laugh at me either. I'll get angry.
We're on cocoa skin.
She banished me to the back of the coach, but secretly I filmed her. It was one of the few times I would get to hear her singing. The following morning, I turned up at Kate's house feeling a little worse for wear. I wasn't the only one.
Hi gang, hi, the riffraff are here, the riffraff are arriving. The Kate goes, hi gang.
It was Harvey's first birthday party. But with just 2 hours sleep, even Kate was in a bad mood.
How do you feel? I'm all right, Richard, don't annoy me today.
Where's his clowning? Come on,
right,
Newton.
Yeah, yeah, come on.
Come on, come on.
Come on, my comfort.
Harvey was diagnosed as blind last year, and other blind children from the Brighton area have been invited to the party. Harvey's health is worrying for the family. Kate's mum told me he was due to have a brain scan soon.
He's got an MRI scan in June or July. We'll see whether he's still got a growth problem or not. At the moment, we don't think he has, but it's something they're monitoring. So we will find out more then. They'll be able to see if the pituitary gland's been affected, and they'll be able to sort of see if he's got any problems with the back of his head with the vision, whatever. There's lots of things they'll look into. So it'll be a good opportunity for them to sort of give him a good going over.
Harvey's dad is the former Manchester United star Dwight York. He and Kate had a tempestuous relationship. They broke up shortly before Kate found out she was pregnant. At first, he denied the baby was his. But not anymore.
Kate and I and the Price family want to thank all of you for coming here this afternoon and to making this event a very much of a success. Want to thank the Blue Event people for putting on such a fantastic venue and entertainment for everybody, and we hope that you all enjoy yourself and wish that we can all get together again sometime. Thank you very much.
Kate and Dwight barely spoke to each other at the party, and when they did, it was quite frosty.
Can you sit in, Mum?
After everyone had gone, Kate opened Harvey's presents and Dwight watched the sport on TV. It was an uncomfortable atmosphere. The next time I saw Kate, I asked her about Dwight and their son.
Were you pleased that Dwight turned up at Harvey's party?
Well, I knew he would anyway, because he hadn't Harvey the night before.
Well, are you pleased that he went?
Well, yeah, so I knew he was going to go anyway, because he had Harvey before. So, yeah, obviously, I'm pleased he went. But he didn't really see Harvey much there, did he? He was too busy watching cricket.
Is he taking quite a good interest in his son now?
He doesn't seem any more than what he did before, but he seems to show more interest. Probably because he's older and he's more fun, isn't he? But yeah, I wouldn't say he sees him any more than what he did before. He sees him about the same. Once in a blue moon.
Really? Does that disappoint you?
It's not down to me, it's down to him.
Yeah, but
building a relationship. No, it's, I've done my bit, I've tried. What more can I do? I'm not gonna keep chasing, saying come and see him, come and see him. It's up to him, isn't it? What relationship he wants with his son.
But obviously you'd like him to have a good one.
Well, wouldn't any mother?
No, I'm not having a go at you.
No, I'm just saying. It's up to him.
Kate has been invited to take part in a charity football tournament. She's a very kinky girl, the kind you don't think home to. We watched her playing. It wasn't very impressive. And her mood was no better.
Knackered.
Her boyfriend Scott looked after Harvey. As the day went on, her temper worsened. So I let her get on with the football. I spotted one of the kings of rock and roll, Rod Stewart, warming up. So I asked him what advice he would give to Kate about her music career.
Just really got to be committed to it, you know. Just can't be something you want to do as a whim. Like some of my kids are trying to go into the business. You've got to dedicate your life to it.
Then I saw her old boyfriend, the singer Dane Bowers. He had been the love of Kate's life, but they split up acrimoniously before she got together with Dwight York. I wondered what he would have to say about Kate's music career.
Would you like a comment of her? I think Kate's...
I told him I wouldn't be able to use that. And could he say something that wasn't rude?
Is that all I can say about it?
I tried again.
I think Kate's That's about it, really.
Kate saw I'd spoken to him, and she came straight over to find out what Dane had said about her.
Say one thing, Rich. Did Dane really say I'm a fucking
I told her yes, but he had only used one of those words. Then she was off to tackle him. From where I stood, it looked quite nasty.
Thank you.
Have you really got it on camera?
I've got it on camera when I talk to him about
but
you.
But not when me and him.
No. I've got it on camera, but I can't hear what you're saying.
But you got it on camera in front of the bottle at me.
Yeah, yeah. What is it you said to him, though?
No, I just said, why'd you call me, like, what he said? And he said, because you are one. And he said, oh, fuck off, and just threw his bottle at me. So I turned back and said, you are the one. You are the C-U-N-T, not me.
Did he really annoy you?
He's obviously so bitter and jealous. I don't know why.
What do you think he's jealous of?
I don't know. And do you know, I don't even like to give him publicity because it's not even worth talking about. The bitter and twisted fat bastard. I don't really care. He was really trying to put me down and trying to make out that he was a big guy from a boy band which finished years ago and that he does a lot of TV. He does nothing. Do you know what I mean? And he was trying to make out that I'm just a two-bit model. But that's fine, Dane. I'll have the last laugh, I always do. I'll love you right down
from the bottom of my heart. After several weeks of filming, I finally saw her in the music studio for the first time. The 10-week deadline was already looking unrealistic.
And again, to the first part.
I know you want me, I can see it in your eyes. It's in your fingertips when you say goodbye. You say you wanna find a girl to share your world. So here I am, come on and take a chance.
When you get to I am,
just your pitch is like...
Just your pitch, but don't try on that part. Don't manage to...
I am.
No, it's the same thing, but just don't, yeah.
Right.
Don't go here, ah, and over try.
Here I am.
Here we go.
It's in your fingertips when you say goodbye.
You say, that
was really
when
out.
When your fingertips when you say goodbye.
Goodbye.
That's the one, sir. All right, here we go.
I know you want me, I can see it in your eyes. It's in your fingertips when you say goodbye. You say you wanna find a girl to share your world. Say here I am, come on and take a chance.
Just chance at the end slightly.
Chance.
Just
right.
The last bit of the note.
Richo, can you not film me for this one?
What time are we doing Wednesday? Sorry. If we say 11.
Yeah.
We will, that means 12 to you. So if we say 11.
Richo, you're here. You're so well,
Richo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So if, we say 11,
if you say, I want this on camera, right?
Yeah, do you know why?
If you say, everyone who's ever going to make an appointment with Kate, any kind of appointment.
We're an hour early.
If you're a hairdresser, if you're a photographer, if you say to Kate, 11 o'clock, she will turn up at 5.30. Not 5, 5.30. If you say to her 12, she will turn up at 8. That's her time schedule. So if you're going to want to link up with her on Wednesday at 11, make sure you get there Thursday at noon.
Kate is back on her lucrative PA circuit. Today, she is flying to Cornwall with Dave.
You want some of that, don't you?
I meet up with her and her boyfriend Scott at her home in Brighton before setting off.
I've not been there.
She's cooking us lunch. And then she told me she's buying a new home.
So you're gonna try my cooking, are you, Mitch?
What is it you're cooking?
Chicken Kiev. Wow, that's really hard to cook.
So you're buying a new house?
Yeah, I'm renting this out. It's going through at the moment, the other house. Doesn't look anything on the picture. But I don't put my address in. That's it.
It's massive.
I'm going to do the whole place, like, done up again.
It was only about a year ago you bought this place, wasn't it?
Yeah, but it's an investment anyway, isn't it?
So do you see property as a way of, like, putting money aside for your old age?
Yes. I hope you're hungry.
So is this a dish that you cook quite a lot?
Yeah, it's just easy, isn't it? 20 minutes and it's done.
Do you cook anything that's complicated?
I cook, well, I don't know. I follow these. That's why I've got so many. My favourite one I like cooking is the shepherd's pie one and the chicken shepherd's pie. Warmer.
Kate is making an appearance at a fun pub in Truro. While she was getting ready, her manager Dave Reed started to criticise Kate for failing to stick to her music schedule.
So what is it that she is badly disciplined at?
Just, you know, little things like she needs to differentiate between the priority of the importance of having her nails done or being in a studio on time or hair extensions being put in, being in the studio on time.
They're the only excuses you could come up with. They're shit.
But they're true.
But all girls do it.
Yeah, no, but not all girls are going to bring out a single and it's going to be a hit this year.
It's your first porno, Rich. I better not do that because people might get the wrong idea again and call me a slapper. Hey, I better not do anything like that because look, they go, oh, look at her, what a slapper, oh, she's such a whore, because I can imagine you all on the sofa at home going to your boyfriend's because you're jealous. Oh, look at her, what a slapper. I told you she's a whore. But you know what? So what? I'm mucking about. They will. They'll be watching me going, oh, look at her. Is it necessary to, like, spray perfume there? Yes, it is, because we get sweaty there.
Oh. Mm. Drink.
Drink? What?
Yeah, I'll get you another one at the bar.
You coming in?
Yeah.
Good boy.
Yeah, good.
This evening, Kate and Dave seem to be on a mission to get hammered.
This is one thing, girls. Girls, do we like revenge on me?
Yeah!
Right. Dwight knows this, but this is nothing new, yeah? Right, Dwight played for Man United at the time, yeah? However, and my ex-boyfriend, Dave Bowen, supported Man United, yeah? Right, Dave Bowen hated the fact that a lot of you white men. Admit, you would not like it if your girlfriend went for a black man, would you? You would like it, would you? Admit. You wouldn't. Right. So what I've done is I found a guy who played for Man United and he was black. It was all revenge. But do you know what? I got a beautiful boy out of it and I'm very proud of him.
I'll be over at 10, you told me time and again, but you're late. I wait around and then I run to the door.
When she got to the stage of signing autographs and posing for photos, she was very, very drunk. So was Dave. When we got back to the hotel, Dave wanted me to film him telling a joke. It involved a pear. But Kate tried to stop me.
Please, Richard.
You've got a lovely pear. Please turn it off.
Richard, what a lovely pear.
Please turn it off, Richard.
Lovely pear.
Right, lovely. Turn it off now.
Richard, what a lovely pear. What a... Rich, come on, laugh at my joke. What a lovely pear.
The wheels on the bus. You're such a Jekyll and Hyde, you are.
All together, everybody.
And you.
Wheels on the bus.
I don't know the words.
Round.
No, round and round.
No, you don't.
It's not round.
Yes, it is.
Go on, then. Let's listen to Nanny sing, shall we, Harvey?
No way.
Today, Kate is going to sign for her new house.
Go on, then.
Round.
In the car, the conversation turned to the baby's father, Dwight. Kate feels he is not paying enough towards his son, and she'd taken a big decision to stop him seeing Harvey.
It just goes to show any man out there, they should think about where they put their willy. They should think about things, what can happen. No, that's true.
Of course it means that women could take better precautions then. Work both ways.
Yeah, I know that. But when I said I'm having it and he was denying it, and he was like saying it weren't his. Just goes to show when arsehole he was, didn't he? Didn't want to know when he was newborn, but now he's starting to be all moving and active. Now he wants to know. I've had to do all the hard work so far, and where's he been?
Yeah, but he does know that. He's no, sorry for what happened. You know
that. I'm so sorry. So sorry that he still doesn't see him at that much.
I'll get you to sign as the buyer.
Just lovely.
Yeah.
As I hide the cost of it.
Yeah. Mm. Nice scribbled out signature. Lovely.
Lovely.
So how much was it?
Never mind.
I'm telling. Let's just say a lot more than my one.
Let's just say quite a few of us wouldn't even be able to afford the stamp duty.
We set off to have a quick peek at the new house. The conversation about Dwight resumed.
So you think he's a nice bloke, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
There you go. He's an arsehole, hasn't got any values of life. All he thinks about is shagging women.
They stopped arguing about Dwight for a few minutes when we reached the house. We shouldn't really have been there.
Shouldn't be doing this, really.
It had 13 acres of land and two ponds.
Well, you must be, you know, really quite wealthy.
Yeah, but I think wealthy people have got money, you don't have to be flash with it.
So all that's yours?
Yeah. And I'm back. Well, all this is it. And this is it. As much as people slate me and put me down, I can't be doing that bad if I can achieve something like this.
As we set off, the argument resumed.
He's not
ugly. He hasn't
got a good
personality, doesn't know how to treat women, he's shit in bed, anything
well,
else.
Listen, that's nothing to do with
there you go.
None of that. But
there you go.
And so it was, all the way home.
I thought it would have been nice for him to be with, like, as a family unit, he's the dad, and it would have been nice for him to be together. And
I want him to see her,
exactly.
This is my kids, but it winds
exactly.
Me up because he doesn't.
I know that, but that's changed.
Kate is heading out to Spain for a celebrity pool party. Dave Reed has come along, and so has Dean Gaffney, who he also represents. Dave and Kate seem more like friends than manager and client. It obviously works. The modelling, the public appearances, and the tabloid stories. He's helped make her rich. Even though this event is like a social occasion to Kate, she's getting paid over £10,000 just to be there for an hour. Her role is simply to be seen and photographed, and it means the event organisers are guaranteed publicity. The guests have all paid £150 for the privilege.
You DJ tonight?
I am. Random block, by the way. We're going to have it.
You nutters.
Have a look round, what a great gap.
But despite the huge paycheck, Kate didn't seem very happy tonight. And she started talking to me about her music career. She seemed very disillusioned.
We're doing tracks but nothing's happening. So I'm yet again thinking, here we go, I'm doing the tracks again and nothing's happening. So I've said to David, bollocks to it, make appointments with all the record companies, just go there with what we've got, just so they can get a taste and hear that I can sing. They're interested, they're not.
With the party in full... We all left early. I caught up with Dave the next day. I asked him about the situation with Kate's music career.
Kate will always proportion blame, you know, her as well as I do. It will always be somebody else's fault, never hers. Not, oh, I've overslept a couple of times, or I've found it more important to do my hair extensions and nails rather than get out of Brighton and get up and get into the studio. What I've decided to do is next week I'm back in England, go back to England tomorrow. We're going to make appointments with the record company A&R guys. Walk in, put it on the table and say, please play this. This is Jordan. Are you interested in working with her, basically?
I was intrigued that Kate and Dave seemed to have different takes on why her music career was stalling. So I tried to get it out in the open over dinner that night.
She does. She has her hair extensions and her nails done more than anybody in the world.
She hasn't done
much, but she does. No, you have it blow dried more than anyone in the world. You know that. You have to admit.
My hair's curly. I can't do it myself.
Okay, we all do in life, me included, right? Sometimes we all need to kick up the arse, don't we?
You know, maybe I haven't been putting my all in going to the studio, but once I've put the deal on, I'm actually seriously on the road doing it. Then I will be there on time. I will be in the studio.
It's about prioritising your time, and sometimes things pop up in life, you have to deal with them, and it's put us behind schedule a little bit, but hey, we're all here, we've all got our health, we're having a nice glass of rosé, and we've got Richard Mayser from the BBC
nice as chairman. Nice shot, ching ching. There's a cutaway for you, Richard.
So there we had it. Everything was all right. The music career was still on track.
Well, I know what the last picture sold on the last Disney show. I know how much they went for.
In London, the plan was that Kate would get back in the studio while Dave began his charm offensive on the record labels.
Bill collectors and my dog. I've just had the meeting with Sony. It went really well. It was really good. Great meeting, played some CDs, they heard Kate's voice, and should hear back from them within a couple of days.
I wondered if Dave was being a bit over-optimistic, and Kate hadn't been back in the studio since Spain. The next time she was in the hairdressers, I decided to ask her about her motivation, but we ended up talking about mine.
You must be quite used to the hairdressing experience.
Yeah. Yes.
So this is where you are when Dave always says that you should be in the recording studio?
No. But obviously I've got to get my hair done, haven't I?
And would you never be prepared to alter that in order to, you know, do more time in the studio?
Well, it's not about being in the studio, is it? You've got to get it done. I'm a model, you can't expect me not to have my nails and hair done. You trying to make me look bad for the documentary or good?
I'm not trying to make you look either good or bad.
That's what I'm trying to say, is how it's having my hair affect me going to the studio.
Are you upset that I'm having this conversation with you?
No, but I don't know what you're trying to twist it around to make me look bad.
I see what all this boils down to, right?
Go on in.
Is that I'm making this film about you.
Yeah.
But you don't really come across as if you really care that much about the singing.
Okay.
Because you don't...
Can I say one thing? Can we interview me at my house with my horses? Because you're winding me up again, Richard. Okay, I'm in here trying to relax, have my hair done, and you're trying to put words in my mouth and I'm not having it.
I stopped filming. But in the car afterwards, Kate made sure I understood who was right.
Right, what I want to say to you is when you interview me next, right, if you're going to ask a question and I'm answering it, remember you're asking me the question. So obviously I know the real answer to the questions you're asking me.
Yeah.
Don't try and change my answer, okay? Like in the hairdressers. I have my hair done all the time, so it doesn't stop me going to the studio, and you're saying, yes, it does. Who knows best, me or you? Who knows me better than you?
Me. You know yourself better.
Thank you. To be professional, I'm only answering your question. Let me answer it without you butting in, okay? Thank you. You may switch camera.
Yeah, just in here on the right, please, mate. By that van anyway, you can park there, that'd be great.
Dave's had another meeting with a record company. He caught up with Kate at a photo shoot, but what he's got to tell her is disappointing. The company's not interested in Kate. They want Jordan.
So, how did your meeting go this morning?
The meeting was fine. The funny thing is, I'm not going to tell you who the meeting was with, because they had some sort of ideas for records, you know, for Kate and stuff, and they'd even got someone to write some lyrics, and it was embarrassing. It was like everything we don't want to do. It was like Sabrina in a swimming pool, boys, that sort of stuff.
Oh,
just
really?
Total cheese, yeah, and it was embarrassing. So I just, thank you very much for being able to be in touch.
What I was going to say, to start with, sounds a little crude, but can you let your legs go through the bars,
yeah,
right, and away from you?
I'll just do different stuff, Martin.
Sure.
Okay.
Hands down low. Further in. Left foot slightly higher. Yes. Good.
Even I could have written better, and I couldn't write. Sorry, it was similar. Like, come on, boys, if you want it, all this.
Oh,
I know.
Yeah.
And I was trying not to laugh.
You got it, showing.
No, just the words I bought.
All right.
But they were sort of really excited. They'd gone, we've spoken to so and so. They're really keen on doing this, and I'm going, yeah, I've got to see some other people.
Did you play my stuff on it?
Yeah, because it is. Yeah.
Oh no.
Brilliant. We got some words, so great and all like that.
No.
Yeah.
But they just they don't want me to do ballet, not saying a word, but when I heard it...
They want you in a bikini, in a swimming pool, with lots of girls holding a beach ball around the back of you, and you've got to go, come on boys, if you want it. And
no.
I was trying not to laugh. Crack me
so
up.
Not what I want to do. So when they bet, they like the stuff then?
Yeah, they bloody have, you know, good voice in that.
Kate and her mum are taking Harvey to a photo shoot in London. But there's bad news. The results from his brain scan are back.
Yeah, Harvey had a scan a couple of weeks ago, MRI scan, and it was to see if there is anything that showed up about the pituitary gland, and that affects like the hormones in the body. And unfortunately, something has shown up, and they are investigating it. It's about three or four, I don't know, it's quite a few hormones. What he's doing, we're waiting to get into Great Ormond Street, and they're going to do further tests on the hormone levels in his body.
But it does annoy me when people like think it's me why he's fat, and you know, when they should do their research properly before they comment.
Like the other night, he had 14 bottles of water in the middle of the night.
I know.
I mean, that kind of thing is the reason why he, you know, he's not a well boy. You know, he needs a treatment for it, really.
The spread is for Now magazine.
Oh, what?
The photographer wants to get a number of shots of Kate with her son. But Harvey is struggling.
I think he likes being cuddled, doesn't he? Give him a minute, we've got a few minutes.
6.4, I think, is normal.
You're taking his temperature?
Yeah.
7.8. Well, we are, actually.
Has he got a high temperature?
I'm saying that with Leo, but it's going up.
After a while, it becomes clear that Harvey is not well enough to go on, and the session is cancelled.
Do you know if we've got a car picking us up here? Well, we'll have to go, Mum, it's not really well.
Kate is to be the face of National Foreplay Day. She's being paid nearly £20,000 for just one photo, and she's being painted from head to toe.
What do you reckon this one does, Kate?
Yeah. I reckon you sit on that.
Yeah. No, yeah.
Ass. That's for ladies who've had babies, I think.
Is he doing
anything?
Mm. There was much in the papers at this time about a new rival to Jordan's crown, called Jodie Marsh. She'd got herself in the press, proclaiming the virtues of natural boobs.
Kate?
Yeah?
Did you see that thing in, I saw something in Closer magazine this week, at how many column inches you've got compared to Jodie? What do you think of all that?
That's pathetic. I don't even know why they compare us anyway. Really.
Do you find it a bit sort of irritating?
No, I'm flattered, but it's like, instead of trying to be like someone, be yourself. And I read something that, something she said, oh, now I've done a cover of a magazine, how does she feel jealous? It's if like she's trying to do it to bother me, but I don't care, do you know? I'm still getting booked. But when she's been going 9 years and still doing it, then I'll hold my hand up to her, not just a few months.
I suppose the thing is that Jodie Marsh being on the scene is at least an indication that one day you will be replaced by someone.
They had Alicia to fill, Lindsay Dawn McKenzie. I'm not bothered about Pinocchio.
So you don't feel at all threatened by her?
You know, like I said, I've been doing it 9 years now. There is room for other people, you know. I can't be in it all the time. I'm getting old, you know. But I'm still working, earning money, good money, so as far as I'm concerned, it's not time for me to give up yet.
Kate was right. There was no real rival to her at the moment, and as a result, her earning potential was huge. But I wondered if she could see beyond this moment of flashlights and fame, beyond the short career that a model expects. Particularly, if her music failed to take off. On the way home, Dave Reed gave me a lift. He told me he'd heard back from the record labels.
So you saw four record companies, did you?
Yeah.
And what's the situation with each of those?
Two are very positive. One hasn't been so rude as to say no, but I get the vibes that it's not really what they're about. And one is sort of very neutral, but I don't think we really want to work with them. They're not really on the par with what we're after.
Are you disappointed that one of them hasn't jumped at the chance of working with Kate?
No, because I think the two people I have got interested, I think it's not a question of jumping, I think they are. They sound great interest. No guarantees, though, of course.
The fact was, after 6 months of trying, Kate's music career had still not taken off.
No.
But that's nothing compared to the worries over Harvey. He's being taken into Great Ormond Street Children's Hospital.
He's in a good mood. But what they're doing now, they're going to take blood tests continually and tests over the next 3 or 4 days to see what hormones he is deficient in. And then obviously we'll find out, and then they'll give us some medication to bring him up. Everything's on it, it'll be on for the rest of his life, but if it makes him like a lot better and brings him on to what he should be, you know, and that's what it's all about. But I bet he turns out to be a monster then.
Kate's decision to stop Dwight York from seeing his son has had an effect. He's gone to the papers and he's threatening a custody battle.
So just tell us, what's this rumour we've heard about the article this morning?
Don't know yet, we haven't seen it. It's apparently that Dwight might be wanting to do a story saying that Kate doesn't allow him to see him, his devoted dad. He wants to come down all the time to see him, that kind of thing. I think the thing is, we've got no problem with him coming down. The problem is he should be paying towards Harvey's keep.
Do you know, all I said I ever wanted was him just to pay my mum's nanny fees, and if he ever needs any, like, you know, so any, I don't know, hospital fees, we both pay half each. It's all I said I wanted. So what is the problem in that? What is really the problem in that?
In the article, Dwight had said that he'd set up a trust fund for Harvey.
Model said, Dwight, I've gone back on his veg to pay for childcare, which is why I have to go to a solicitor to get maintenance I don't know why you never went to the child support agency in the first place. It would have been done and sorted by now.
He kept dragging it along, didn't he? Saying, yeah, I'm going to pay, I don't mind, I'm going to pay. But did he not keep saying he's going to? And you know, it's been 16 months. I'm not even worried, Mum. I'm glad I did put a stop to the scene. It's only been 4 weeks, but at least it's made him realise now, isn't it?
Yeah.
But he never even saw him every week anyway. One time, he only saw him once in 10 weeks.
Well, I think all this story is saying that he's threatened to take her to court.
Yeah, but that's a threat, because I'm the one taking him.
I know that, but what he's saying is because he wants to see Harvey and you're stopping him to see Harvey.
I have done the past 4 weeks, yeah. Right. But at least it's made him realise and now he's acting. Yeah. It's not really about the money, but the principle is he should pay something towards his son, like any father would do.
It's interesting that you're having to think that far forward into the sort of the future when, you know, you won't be a model and things like that. Do you think about that much?
Well, no, I take each day as it comes, but obviously you have to think of the future. No one knows what's going to happen to anyone. No one knows, do they?
So just supposing that you cease to be a celebrity from tomorrow,
yeah.
Would you, in a year's time or something, would you take an ordinary job?
No, I should open an agency, a model agency.
That's
which
what
I would do anyway, yeah. I mean, there's loads of things I would do. Those things I can do.
One thing was certain. Harvey would need all the support Kate could give him for the rest of his life.
Where were we?
Best of luck, Kate.
See you later, Rich.
Thanks a lot. Be in touch in a few days.
We're going wrong. Basically, a secure area
for you to
park
there,
no problem. There's no one
in
the
room.
Brilliant.
See you,
Richard. See ya.
I was anxious to hear what had happened with Harvey, but it was a few weeks before we could meet for one final time.
Two sugars for me.
Do you want one then?
Oh, God. No, I'm alright actually.
Do you want one really?
No.
Right, you've got one
there.
Richard.
So what were the findings when he went into Great Ormond Street for those tests?
They found a couple of things wrong with him, which we knew anyway. So he's on medication now for the rest of his life, for them two things. It's one's through thyroid, he's underactive, and the other one is called diabetes insipidus.
Have you told Dwight about these developments?
No. When he was in hospital for the whole week, he knew he was in, but obviously he couldn't come down because obviously I've got this situation going on with the solicitors, but a phone call still would have been nice to see, you know, to show an interest in his son, but I'm still waiting for that phone call. And it's been 4 weeks now. Dwight, if you're watching this, this is your son. Please take time out to see him more often. Not just once in a blue moon when it suits you. Right, go on.
Well, I think you'll get the message.
Good.
What's the latest with the music then?
Oh, well, with the music, you tell me. It's just what has happened with it. I mean, I'm sick of it now. I don't know what to do. I mean, I've said to Dave, it's been months and months.
Do you think the record industry probably thinks that maybe you haven't got the right sort of profile for them to sell records?
Well, it'd be fun to help change it.
Yeah, but do you think that might...
I have the same old, same old. Obviously, I know the image I've got out there is the tits out and everything, but come on, please, everyone knows that's my job, that's that.
If it's not going to happen in the singing, why don't you just accept that? And,
well, it will happen. And, I haven't been given the chance yet.
And enjoy, you know, the rest of your modelling career.
Because my singing hasn't been given a chance, and why are you doubting it, Richard?
No, I'm not doubting it at all. I'm just saying...
Well,
you know,
it's nothing to finish yet, because I haven't even begun it, so...
Yeah, but Dave has been around a few record labels.
Yeah, my music manager, is he? He's my manager and everything. I gave him the chance to see, because he said he'd try. And obviously he hasn't, so yet again I'll have to find a music manager or do something myself. I don't know what the next step is, but I still haven't tried or attempted the music career yet. And if it doesn't work over here, I should go to Germany.
I think that you know, deep down inside, you're probably a bit fed up with being seen as just a pair of tits, and you want people to take you seriously as a creative person.
No one will ever take me seriously, Richard. You've got to remember that. No one will ever. And in people's eyes, I'm a joke, but I'm a successful joke. I've been around 9 years. I know what I'm doing. I play it well, as they say. So I will try the music. Careful with that camera, because she will freak.
I had known Kate for nearly 3 years, and I had been with her through some of the most momentous times in her life. But when we came to say goodbye, we both seemed a bit stuck for words.
So, all right, I'll get a shot of you just to end the film. We'll get a shot of you just riding off into the distance.
Okay. Well, who knows? Maybe there'll be another time, maybe there might not be. But, what are you doing, Sally? So, wait. So I suppose we'll say goodbye from here then.
Yeah. Well, take care of yourself.
Okay. See you later.
Bye.